What made you transition from, say, the hand drawing to iPad exclusively?
I think the best way to describe it was like Photoshop was probably my entryway to doing digital illustration. And I just wanted to be as mobile as possible. And then when the iPad came out, I was like, oh, this might be pretty cool to do some work on. And I don't think I intended to make it be like my main device for creating artwork, but it ended up just being so handy and so much fun. And I just got a lot of traction out of it. And they just kept updating these applications. So that, the tactile feedback was so good. I was like, whoa, okay, I can just illustrate something, email it to a client, get feedback, make revisions if I need to, and then just keep going on with the process like that. So it's like my toolkit is all in one place. And whereas before I had to carry around like I use like a lot of colored pencils and oils and acrylics. So I'd have to like have a whole entire set of things if I wanted to create something. But like I've taken this thing abroad, like all sorts of trips I've been on. And it's just been like incredible.
And what's the current software that you're using to actually illustrate and paint in?
So I've got an iPad Pro. It was a gift from Apple. I got very fortunate to be kind of like a brand ambassador for them for a little
Really?
bit. And so I was just networking with them. I created a few illustrations, put it online, promote their product. I've done some courses with them and like some of their Apple stores like pre-COVID, and the deal was like you use this application, you're a freelancer, just let us know what you're up to, report back to us, let us know how you like the iPad, and if you find any bugs, just let us know. So I was probably doing that for like maybe 3 or 4 years. Each time an iPad would come out, they would send it my way, and it was a really great deal. Saved me like thousands of dollars.
They kept sending you other ones?
I mean, I they so. The crazy thing is they would have these events in Tribeca, and I got invited to one of them, and it went so well. They're like, all right, we'll have you back for the next one. And so I would just request them and say, okay, like, when's the next one coming out? Like, can I use it? And the original agreement was I was supposed to give them back, but they were like, no, like, we like your work you're doing. Like, just keep it. I was like, oh, okay. I'm not complaining.
Now you just got them stacked up and you're using them for furniture. You have so many of them. Well, okay. So
Pretty much.
here's what I want to know. How did you get in that situation in the first place? Like how do you approach
Yeah,
that?
that's a good story too. That's a good story. So I've got a friend, he's an illustrator. He does a lot of work for the New Yorker and a few other different publications too. Like he's very, very good. His name is George Colombo. And
Great
George
name.
was doing a lot of watercolor. Yeah, he's a really cool guy. Doing a lot of watercolor illustrations, comics, and things like that for different magazines. And then the iPhone came out, and he really blew up because he started doing iPhone paintings in New York, where he's based. And so TV interviews and all this other kind of stuff. So after that, the iPad comes out later. He starts using that. He's getting a lot of acclaim for using this device now. It's on a bigger screen. So he's using the iPad to do these New Yorker magazine covers. I was like, oh, this guy's work is really great. And I was going to New York, kind of following his footsteps and creating like these urban landscape paintings, like the Empire State Building, Chrysler Building. And I got the idea. I was like, oh, let me turn this into a book. Like, that'd be pretty cool. And George had done the same thing previously. So I was getting a lot of inspiration from him. So I had an opportunity to meet him at the Museum of Modern Art, where he was doing a workshop. I was like, cool, like I'll introduce myself, if we hit it off, like maybe something will come of it. So it went over really well, like where he's looking over my shoulder to see what I'm working on in the workshop. I was like, oh, okay, it's going really well. And then so afterward, I said, hey, I'm working on this book, like I love your work. Like, do you think like you'd be willing to look at some of my pieces and like do a little write-up for me? So he does the foreword to my book, and then he does the foreword to my second book that I'm self-publishing through Lulu, and it just turns into like this great friendship and mentorship, and I'm going to him for advice, and he's asking me things about what I know too. So it's like we're both getting something out of it, and it's really cool. And he says, "Hey, I can't make this event that Apple is doing. It's going to be in Tribeca at this restaurant. Like, do you want to go and network? Like, you can go in my place." I was like, yeah, sure. So I went and I made such a great impression that they invited me to other events. And that's how I ended up getting the iPads.
Oh, wow. And so it was because, obviously you made a friendship with the guy and that's super cool, but really it was just a missed date and you took his place and then it was like, okay, now you're in. Oh, man, I hate you so much. No, I'm kidding.